A very good morning to all my lovely students. I hope you all are fine at your place. So today, 9th standard, I'm taking chapter 4th of your English syllabus, A Truly Beautiful Mind. What this chapter, what name indicates? A truly beautiful mind, a mind which is truly beautiful. It means that a person who is minded, genuine, doesn't mean that he is noble or kind-hearted. Maybe he is using his intelligence in a wrong way, like your criminals, these terrorists, they are also minded. How? Because they plan everything so secretly, and how they manage, this is also a work of mind, but they are not beautiful mind people. Why? Because they are doing ill activities. So here we are taking one scientist whose name is Albert Einstein, and how beautiful mind he was having. So his autobiography is discussed here, and how he spent his childhood, boyhood, adulthood, everything we'll discuss in this chapter. So let's, without wasting any time, let's take the chapter. Albert Einstein was born on 14th March 1879 in the German city of Ulm. L is silent here, without any indication that he was destined for greatness. So Albert Einstein, when he was born, like other children, he was also a newborn baby. Nobody even thought of that he will be so much great, that he will be known for ages. So there was nobody knew it, that his destiny is of greatness. On the contrary, his mother thought Albert was a freak. On the contrary, his mother's observation was that Albert, who was a newborn baby of her, so she thought that this boy is abnormal. This is half-minded, abnormal kind of child this is. How? Why? To her, his head seemed much too large. Why she thought so? Because his head was too much large as compared to other newborn babies. So this was something weird that she realized, and she thought that this child may be abnormal child. This is not a normal child. But yes, exactly, it was not a normal child, because he was a great scientist later on. But at that time, everybody thought that this is a freak. Freak, I can say that half-minded or abnormal child. At the ages of 2.5, Einstein still wasn't talking. Now, this is another problem. Many problems he was having during his childhood. Students, many problems. First, his head was very big. Another problem was that up to 2.5 years, he was not able to talk. Generally, a child starts speaking after 1 year. 1.5 years, a child starts using single words, short words, child starts speaking. But he was not able for 2.5 years. When he finally did learn to speak, he uttered everything twice. This is the third problem. When finally he started speaking, he repeated everything twice, like what, is, when, like this he used to speak everything twice. So this was also really very weird. Einstein didn't know what to do with other children. It means that he doesn't know what the social relationship is, how we play with other students. No. He didn't know how to play, how to talk with other persons. And his playmates called him Brother Boring. And this is the name that other children given him, Brother Boring. So this question can be asked, that why other children called him Brother Boring. So the youngster played by himself much of the time. So this was the reason that this youngster, who Albert Einstein, he used to play alone, because he was not social. He couldn't adjust with the social behavior with other students, other children. He especially loved mechanical toys. This is the generally habit of every boy. They like mechanical toys only. If a small 2-3 year old boy you are having at your home, you might have noticed that he used to play with mechanical toys like plane, car, bikes, and like that only. So like that, Albert Einstein also liked mechanical toys. But there is a limit of that. How much he was indulged in the mechanical world, you can have an idea after reading next line. Looking at his newborn sister Maja, you might laugh at the name, but this is a German name, so Germany country where he was born. So when his sister was born, Maja, he is said to have said, what he said, fine, but where are her wheels? He said, okay, fine, she is my sister, but where are her wheels? It shows that how much mechanical his mind was. He was small, so we can expect a small kid saying all these things. So now see, third point. A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter because he'll never make a success at anything. One thing I want to say here, those students, those are weak in studies, na? There is a hope for them, especially in the class 9th A or 9th B, whatever it is. So from Albert Einstein, you can learn a lot. Why? Because his headmaster said to his father that it doesn't matter whatever profession he choose, he'll never make a success at anything. Why? Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted him to. He later became a gifted amateur violinist, maintaining the skill throughout his life. So student, he was good for nothing, for school, for teachers. I would like to say here that Albert Einstein never cooperated with his teachers, and his headmaster was also not having any hope for him. So they said that this boy is a freak, he will do nothing in the life, he is a complete waste. His mother, she wanted her to learn violin. So at the age of 6, he started learning that, and throughout life, he was a good violinist. This is the another, apart from a great scientist, he was a good musician also. This is important part that we get to know from this third point. Now further, but Albert Einstein was not a bad pupil. He was not bad, but he was different. His observations were different. His way of thinking was different. He went to high school in Munich. Again, this H is silent, Munich, where Einstein's family had moved when he was 15 months old. When Albert Einstein was only 15 months old, his family shifted to Munich and scored good marks in almost every subject. Einstein hated the school's regimentation and often clashed with his teachers. As I told earlier also, he actually never believed in the school system. He doesn't like the way that are taught in the school, that all, if suppose 35 students are there in the class and 35 students are having different interest, 35 students are having different mindset, and a single teacher is teaching all of them in a single way. This is the way that Albert Einstein almost hated. So the school's regimentation means school's arrangements, discipline and everything. And he often clashed with his teacher. As I told, he never adjusted, never cooperated with his teachers. You find it very strange. Please don't think that this is allowed to do. But yes, he doesn't like all these things. At the age of 15, Einstein felt so stifled there. Stifled means unable to breathe or suffocated, that he left the school for good. At the age of 15, he left the school. Why? Because he tried his best, but he wasn't able to adjust in that scenario. He wasn't able to adjust in the school, that he has to left the school. Very interesting. The previous year, Albert's parents had moved to Milan and left their son with relatives. After a prolonged discussion, Einstein got his wish to continue his education in German-speaking Switzerland, in a city which was more liberal than Munich. So Albert has to, you know, make much efforts to convince his parents to left the school, and he decided to take a course in German-speaking, and somehow he managed all these things and he left that place, Munich. So you can say that he never attended school. At the age of 15, he left the school. Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics, and after finishing school, he decided to study at the university in Zurich. Zurich is the name of a place. So he was a gifted mathematician, means he was highly talented in maths, and he was interested in physics also. As you all are studying this also, you find that math and physics are somewhere connected also. So he decided to study in the University of Zurich. But science wasn't the only thing that appealed to the dashing young man with the walrus mustache. Walrus mustache is a kind of mustache, big one, you can see in the picture. Fine, this 1955 picture, the kind of mustache he is having, this is called walrus mustache. So only science was not his interest. His interest were in many things, but all that was related to something, creativity. Now see, he also felt a special interest in a fellow student, Malvia Marik. So Malvia Marik was a fellow student. She was studying with her, and he also felt something for her, whom he found to be a clever creature. Clever creature, obviously, the way you are, the type of student you are, ultimately you will be attracted towards the same. If you are intelligent, then you will like the company of intelligent student, and if you are mischievous, then you will sit in the group of mischievous student only. So Malvia Marik, she was also very clever, and he called her clever creature, and he felt special interest towards her. This young Serb had come to Switzerland because the university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees. And this girl was from Serb. Serb is also name of a place. And she was also studying in University of Zurich, because at that time only this university in Europe was giving admission to women. So beta, these are the, you know, very back when girls were not given much importance, almost even in European country also they were not given importance. So that's why this Maria Marik was studying there. Einstein saw in her an ally against the Philistines. Here it is given, a word used to disapproving to talk about people who don't like art, literature or music. Now see, what Einstein saw in her an ally against the Philistines, those people in his family and at university with whom he was constantly at odds. The couple fell in love. Letters survive in which they put their affection into words. So later they decided to get married. Both of them were having same interest in art and craft and music and studies. So that's why they felt attraction for each other, and later they decided to get married. Mixing science with tenderness, wrote Einstein, how happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought our work on the relativity to a victorious conclusion. So they were working on the theory of relativity. You might have studied in the science, and Einstein has written, we were extremely happy when both of us together worked and make it a successful conclusion. So in 1900, at the age of 21, Albert Einstein was of 21 year old. Albert Einstein was a university graduate and unemployed. See student, how much struggling time he was having. He was university graduate from which university? University of Zurich, and he was unemployed. He worked as a teaching assistant, gave private lessons, and finally secured a job in 1902. So 1902, he was able to get a job as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern. While he was supposed to be assessing other people's inventions, Einstein was actually developing his own ideas in secret. Though he was working there as an assistant, but he was developing his own ideas. Somehow, from the back of all that situation, he was having his own ideas that he was secretly working on that. He is said to have jokingly called his desk drawer at work the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. Theoretical physics in the sense bureau where he was sitting, he used to kept his notes also, he used to do his work also. So in private, without the help of anyone, he was doing his own research. One of the famous papers of 1905 was Einstein's special theory of relativity, according to which time and distance are not absolute. This you have already studied or you are going to study in your physics. Indeed, two perfectly accurate clocks will not continue to show the same time if they come together again after a journey if one of them has been moving very fast relative to the other. From this followed the world's most famous formula, which describes the relationship between mass and energy, E is equal to mc square. So this is the formula, E is equal to mc square. Either you have studied up to 8th or you are going to study in 9th. So this 9th paragraph you'll understand in your physics term also. So in short, here we can say that Einstein has developed this formula, theory of relativity, E is equal to mc square. Come to the 10th one. While Einstein was solving the most difficult problems in physics, his private life was unraveling. Private life, you remember na, he got married with Malvia Marika. So his personal life was not so good. it was complete failure. Albert had wanted to marry Malvia right after finishing his studies, but his mother was against it. So first, sorry, I told it a complete failure. That is the later part. First, here we will discuss that he wanted to marry that girl, but his mother was not against, was not in favor of that. She thought Malvia, who was 3 years older than her son, was too old for him because age gap. Mother was not agreed. She was also bothered by Malvia's intelligence. She's a book like you, his mother said. Einstein put the wedding off. So what her mother said, mother, she's a book like you. She's as crazy about studies as you are. I don't want her to be in your life. And that's why Albert Einstein put the wedding off. Delayed the wedding. Put the wedding off means delayed the wedding. The pair finally married in January 1903 and had 2 sons. So somehow they managed the marriage and they were having 2 twins, 2 sons also. But a few years later, the marriage flattered, became weak. They started fighting. Malvia, meanwhile, was losing her intellectual ambitions and becoming an unhappy housewife. What was the reason? That Malvia was highly intelligent and she doesn't want it to be a housewife. After years of constant fighting, the couple finally divorced in 1919. Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. So, after having divorce with Malvia, he married his cousin Elsa. Now, you might feel it weird that cousin. So, in Western culture, students, it allowed that they can marry with their cousins also. So, this is the German culture. We can't raise a question on this. So, Albert Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. It means in 1919. Einstein's new personal chapter coincided with his rise to the world fame. In 1915, he had published his journal Theory of Relativity, which proved a new interpretation of gravity. So this formula that he has given, E is equal to mc square, the theory of relativity. So this was giving many new ideas to the upcoming scientist. An eclipse of the sun in 1919 brought proof that it was accurate. So it was tested whether the theory that he is going, whether it is correct or not, and it was proved that whatever Einstein has said about the time, mass and energy, everything is accurate. Einstein had correctly calculated in advance the extent to which the light from fixed stars would be deflected through the sun's gravitational field. The newspaper proclaimed his work as a scientific revolution. Now student, now it is common. But in 1900, in 1903, 1902 and whatever he was, in which year he was working, it was a scientific revolution. Why? Because this was the first time when he has given this formula. Einstein received the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. He was showered with honors and invitation from all over the world and lauded by the press. So he was highly popular and obviously, every country wanted him to work in their country so that they can discover new things, they can be more powerful. You can understand why this brain drain system that an intelligent people countries wanted them to work in their own country so that they can have benefit of that. So he was having shower of invitations from all over the world and he was loaded by press. When the Nazis came to power in Germany in 1933, Einstein immigrated to US. So he went to USA when Germany, you might have studied it this, if not then you will study in 10th standard or in SS you might have studied. In Germany the situation was not good in 1933, the Nazis were torturing people. So Einstein migrated to US. 5 years later, the discovery of nuclear fission in Berlin had American physicists in an uproar. Many of them had fled from fascism, just as Einstein had, and now they were afraid the Nazis could build and use an atomic bomb. So science is having both curse and blessings also. When this physicist has made this nuclear weapon, so they were afraid that Nazis could misuse it. At the urging of a colleague, Einstein wrote a letter to the American president. So in America, they made it. You remember this American's nuclear attack on Japan. So this is a matter of that time. So when they made this nuclear weapon, so now Albert Einstein was worried it shouldn't be misused. So he wrote letter to the American president of that time, Franklin D. Roosevelt, on 2nd August 1939, in which he warned, what he said, a single bomb of this type exploded in a port might very well destroy the whole port together with the sum of the surrounding territory. So he is telling, first time it was introduced, nuclear bomb. So he was giving warning that how much destruction this nuclear bomb can do to the world. So he is alerting, he is warning to American president that though we have made it, but please be careful on watching, on using this nuclear weapon. His words didn't fail to have an effect. The Americans developed the atomic bomb in a secret project of their own. So, by taking ideas from these scientists, Americans developed the atomic bomb and dropped it on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki in August 1945. So, in 1945, they dropped this, bomb, nuclear bomb. Einstein was deeply shaken by the extent of the destruction. And you also know how much destruction this bomb had on Japan. Even still today, it is affecting them. And that's why Japan has totally banned US. They don't sell or purchase US product at all. So Einstein was deeply shaken by this extent of destruction. This time, he wrote a public missive to the United Nations. In it, he proposed the formation of a world government. Unlike the letter to Roosevelt, this one made no impact. Though he was again and again requesting and warning government, don't use science as a curse. But government was not listening. US government was not listening. But over the next decade, Einstein got over more involved in politics, agitating for an end to the arms building up and using his popularity to campaign for peace and democracy. So now, as his science was misused, so Albert Einstein also started joined politics, and he also giving a peace and democracy message to the people. When Einstein died in 1955 at the age of 76, he was celebrated as a visionary and world citizen as much as a scientific genius. So when he died in 1955, after 10 years of this attack at Japan, 10 years he worked for the peace and democracy also. So not only a scientist, he was a good citizen and he was good social reformer also. And he was known as a visionary and world citizen. Why world citizen? Because he has worked for humanity. He was not limited with any particular country. He was dealing with the whole world for the benefit of whole world. Because scientists, when they discover something new, that is beneficial for whole world. So he was a really scientific genius. So by this way, students, we can say that Albert Einstein was truly having a beautiful mind.